How does it feel to you?
I don't know.
Okay, so let's find out what's in this place. What else do you see besides green?
I see like a fence.
A fence? Mm-hmm. Describe this fence. What's it made out of?
It's like a very weak iron.
Mm-hmm. Like a weak iron fence?
Mm-hmm. With a lot of vines.
Mm-hmm. The vines are on the fence?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How tall is this fence?
Not tall.
How are you in relationship to this fence? Are you next to it or below it?
I see it from afar.
From afar, okay. So tell me, what else do you see? Look around you.
I think...
What does it feel like?
Like an old castle.
Like an old castle? Mm-hmm. Let's get closer and see what it looks like. Get closer and see what's there. What do you imagine this place looks like?
There's no one.
There's no one there. Mm-hmm. Is this an abandoned castle?
It's kept well, so...
Mm-hmm. It's kept well? But mm-hmm. There's no one, no life around?
No.
Mm-hmm. While you're looking at this castle, I'd like for you to focus on yourself. Look down at your feet. Can you see any feet below you?
I think I don't have shoes.
Mm-hmm. You barefoot?
Mm-hmm.
What do your feet look like? Are they male or female feet?
I think I'm female.
Mm-hmm. What color is your skin?
White.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel like you're young or old?
Very young.
Very young? About what age would you think? Are you a young girl?
Teenager.
A teenager. Very good. And I'd like for you to imagine, just pretend that you have a spiritual mirror in front of you and you could see what you look like. Do you see yourself wearing there?
I don't see my face, but I see my hair is brown.
Mm-hmm. What else?
I'm wearing like a fancy, like a greenish brown ruffle dress.
How long is this dress?
To almost the bottom, I think.
Mm-hmm.
I think I also have a hat.
Mm-hmm. What kind of hat is that?
Like a fancy 1700s, I think.
Mm-hmm. 1700s. Are you carrying anything there? Look in your hands and see if you are carrying anything.
I think a basket.
A basket. Do you imagine inside of this basket? Is it empty or does it have something in there?
I think it's something to eat.
Okay. So you think perhaps it's a little snack that you're carrying with you?
But not for me only.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out what's in there. What's in that basket? Take a look and see.
I think there's bread.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe grapes.
Mm-hmm. Grapes. Very good. And I want you to imagine, what is the reason why you're out in the countryside today? What are you doing out there without your shoes on? How do you feel?
I think I'm supposed to be joined by somebody.
You're supposed to be with somebody?
Or somebody's supposed to meet me there.
All right, so let's find out who's going to meet you there. Advance the scene and allow that person to show up.
I see a guy.
Mm-hmm. I see a guy.
Really good looking.
Mm-hmm. How is he dressed?
Those fancy 1700.
Mm-hmm. What happens next?
I don't know. I think somebody else is coming.
Okay. How do you feel?
Fine.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out who else is coming. Allow that person to show up.
I think they're coming in a, like a carriage, mm-hmm. or a wagon.
Yes.
And I think they're older.
Mm-hmm. Who are they?
Maybe my relatives.
Mm-hmm. As you see them approach, how does it make you feel?
Nothing.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens when they come. What happens next?
We just put the stuff together to have a picnic or mm-hmm. something like that.
Mm-hmm. So are you all having a picnic in this place?
I think so.
Mm-hmm. I want you to dig deep into your emotions and tell me how you feel with your family and this gentleman with you.
I think the elderly people are like my grandparents, not my mother.
Mm-hmm. They're your grandparents. Do you feel your parents are missing?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What's the first thing that comes into your mind as you think about where your parents are?
Like they don't care.
Mm-hmm. And who is this man that's with you?
He has a very gleaming face, very handsome.
Handsome. How do you feel about this man?
I don't know.
Does he seem somebody that is familiar? Or is someone that perhaps is there just to meet you?
I think he likes me.
He likes you. How do you feel about him?
Nothing.
Nothing. So he likes you, but you don't like him.
I realize that he's handsome, but...
Mm-hmm, but that's it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Very good. So let's close that scene, and now let's see what happens after this picnic. What's the next significant event in that lifetime? What happens next? Allow the pictures to come.
I think we're inside a house.
Mm-hmm, inside a house. What kind of house is this?
An old house.
What kind of house? A log house?
Like... like an old house with a lot of candles.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's a party.
There's a party, okay. Is this house a fancy house or is it a humble house?
No, it's a fancy house.
A fancy house. So let's see what this party is all about. Go ahead and describe everything.
Everybody's like... Or is it like maybe like a not a hotel, but like different families are there having fun.
Mm-hmm. Is this like a ball, perhaps?
Not as fancy as a ball. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
Do you feel that this is high society?
Not high. Mm-hmm.
What are these people dressed like?
Like fancy dresses, but not gold or
not like extravagant. They're just plain nice dresses. So what do you think the purpose of this gathering is? I'd like for you to just trust your first impression. What's the reason for this gathering?
I think it's a holiday.
A holiday. Let's find out what holiday it is that you're celebrating.
I don't know.
Mm-hmm. What do people do when they gather for this holiday? What do you see them doing?
I think they're supposed to eat.
Mm-hmm. Do you have anything to do with the meal preparation?
No, I don't see food.
Okay. What is it that you're seeing right now? What are the people doing?
Waiting, mm-hmm. talking,
mm-hmm.
maybe dancing.
How do you feel at this place? Are you enjoying yourself?
I'm just watching.
I'm just watching. Very good. So let's now go to the time where you're all eating. See yourself at the table. Let's see what it looks like there.
Very, like, rustic.
Mm-hmm.
Candles.
Mm-hmm.
I'm wearing a yellow dress.
A yellow dress.
My hair has curls and bows.
Is your hair up or down?
Kind of, sort of, in between.
Mm-hmm. Is it long,
the hair? It's long.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
Very young. 15.
15. Mm-hmm. So what is it that you're eating? Take a look at the food in front of you.
I think some fruits.
Some fruits? How were they served?
Casual, not fancy. Mm-hmm.
Casual, very good. Who do you see around the table with you?
The handsome guy.
Mm-hmm.
He's to my right.
Is he young like you, or is he older?
A little bit older.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel he's head over heels.
Mm-hmm. And how do you feel about him now? Nothing.
I don't know.
So who else is at the table?
I think the people who are at the picnic.
Mm-hmm. The older people?
Yes.
Go ahead and gauge who they are.
I think they're my grandparents.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't think my parents are alive.
Do you feel that you have any brothers and sisters?
No.
Mm-hmm. You're on your own?
I think so. I think the elderly people take care of me.
Mm-hmm.
They raised me.
They raised you. I want you to think back in your mind and allow the first thing that pops into your mind. Let's see. What do you feel happened to your parents?
I think they were leaving for another country.
Mm-hmm. They were leaving and they left?
In a boat.
Mm-hmm.
No, I think they were killed.
They were killed?
They were leaving in like a huge ship.
Mm-hmm.
Spanish ship. Something happened.
Mm-hmm. They were killed on that ship.
Something happened, maybe a hurricane.
Mm-hmm. And they never returned. So you've been with your grandparents ever since. Did this happen when you were very small?
I think so. I think I saw them leave.
Mm-hmm.
When I was very little. And I waved goodbye to them while my grandmother was carrying me.
Mm-hmm.
My grandmother is fat.
Mm-hmm.
And kind of ugly.
Mm-hmm.
But loving.
But she loves you. Mm-hmm. What does your grandfather look like?
I think he's an old man.
Mm-hmm. What do they call you in that life? What do your grandparents call you?
I think Sophia.
Mm-hmm. When I say the name Sophia, does that sound right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And Sophia, what country are you in?
I think England.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So Sophia, let's close that scene and now let's go to another important scene in that lifetime. You're older now and something important is happening. See yourself there. Tell me what happened, Sophia.
I think I had children.
Mm-hmm. So let's find out. I want you to see yourself there. And tell me where you are.
I'm in a house. Arranging dinner.
Mm-hmm. What are you cooking?
No, I'm not cooking.
Mm.
I'm telling the people what to cook.
Okay.
What to do.
You have servants there?
I think so.
Mm-hmm. How many do you see?
Maybe three.
Mm-hmm. Is this house that you live in large?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So tell me what's happening. What's important about this event? Who's coming for dinner?
I don't know.
Let's find out. Advance the scene. Look around you. Who's there with you?
Family from the guy's far side.
Mm-hmm.
His sister.
His sister. Who else is there?
He's there.
Mm-hmm. Your husband?
I don't know if he's my husband.
How does he feel to you?
Like a pretty face.
Like a pretty face. What does he do for a living?
Something to do with horses.
With horses. Do you feel you married him just to get married? Without love?
I don't feel love for him.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that he still loves you?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So take a look around and see who else is sitting at the table with you besides your husband and the sister.
I think they're children.
Mm-hmm. Are these your children?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How old are they?
Little, like five, mm-hmm. two.
Five and two. Can you see their faces?
It's a little girl, she's five, little boy still.
Mm-hmm. Take a look at their faces. The eyes are always the window to the soul. As you look inside their eyes, tell me if they feel familiar in anybody in Alina's life. Do they seem...
The little girl looks like my daughter.
Mm-hmm. What about the little boy?
No.
No? Okay. Anybody else around the table? Look in their eyes and see if any of them are familiar. Your husband, his sister.
My husband now reminds me of my father.
Mm-hmm. Anybody else?
Somehow, I'm thinking about my father's father.
Mm-hmm.
Don't know why.
Okay, very good. Do you feel that your husband is your father's father?
No.
All right. So let's close that scene now. Close that scene like a book. And I'd like to, for you to travel through time and space to another time in that same lifetime when something very important is happening. You're older now. Open the scene and see what's there. Where are you?
I don't know. I think we're leaving the house.
Mm-hmm. We're leaving the house.
Or moving.
Mm-hmm. Tell me what's happening.
The kids are bigger.
Mm-hmm. How old are they now?
10.
Mm-hmm.
I am very good looking.
Mm-hmm.
I have a beautiful dress. My hair is beautiful. I make a nice couple with my husband.
Mm-hmm.
And now I think I kind of like him better.
You like him better now?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He's grown to you on you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
He now looks a lot like my father.
Mm-hmm.
When he was younger. Very handsome.
So let's see where you go. Where are you moving to?
We're moving like to the city.
Mm-hmm. Tell me what happens next. Where do you go?
I think he's opening a business.
Mm-hmm. What is this business? Do you know?
Like a hardware?
Mm-hmm. A hardware business?
Or lumber?
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about this move?
I like it.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be in the city.
You'll be in the city. Is that more exciting?
More people.
More people.
We live in the country.
Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel?
Boring.
Have you always lived in the country?
I think so.
Mm-hmm.
It's a beautiful country place. But it's not the city.
Mm-hmm. So I'd like for you now to see yourself living in the city. Transport yourself there now. You've already moved in. And tell me where you are.
I'm getting like bread or something from the from the market.
Mm-hmm. Tell me what this place looks like.
It's pretty. Nice homes next to each other.
Mm-hmm.
bright white.
The homes are bright white?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, next to each other, like. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't know.
What are they made out of?
Wood.
Wood?
Mm-hmm. With front iron fences.
With iron fences.
And you hear the carriages and the horses in the street.
Seems like there's a lot of activity there.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Are you walking on foot?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So how old do you feel there now?
32.
Mm-hmm. So Sophia, let's see what happens next. Where do you go?
I'm going to the house where I live.
Mm-hmm. What's it look like?
It's a nice black and white floor. Pretty. And it's a lady. I think it's my maid following me.
Mm-hmm. What does she call you?
Ma'am, or?
Mm-hmm. Very good. So let's see what happens next. What does this place look like?
It's a cheerful town.
Mm-hmm.
The house, the kids are running around, playing.
Mm-hmm.
They're cooking something, that we're gonna have lunch.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel in this life?
Happy.
Very good. So now let's go, Sophia, and you're a lot older. See yourself going traveling through time to another significant event in that same lifetime. Let's see what happens next.
I think somebody died.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out who it is.
I think I'm at a funeral home or my house or somebody's house that they're the wake is there.
Mm-hmm. The wake is at the house.
Mm-hmm. I think it's my grandfather.
How do you feel?
Fine. He was old.
Mm-hmm. What's interesting about this scene? Take a look at it. See if you could describe it.
I think we inherit something.
Mm-hmm.
After he passed away. It's gonna make us like more have more houses or.
Mm-hmm. Was your grandfather wealthy?
I don't know, maybe he had more farms.
Mm-hmm.
But we have to take care of my grandmother.
All right, so what happens now with your grandmother?
I think she's gonna live with us.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't like it.
Why is that?
She's difficult.
Mm. Take a look at your grandmother's eyes and see if you recognize her in the life of Alina.
She reminds me of my real grandmother.
Mm-hmm.
She doesn't like my husband. She thinks he's too nice and weak.
Mm-hmm. How does that make you feel?
She should mind her own business.
Mm-hmm.
But she's like persistent and talks behind our back,
mm-hmm.
putting him down. And I hate it.
So what happens?
I confronted her. She made me cry.
What did she say to you?
She didn't know that she was hurting me.
Mm-hmm. Is she understanding now?
She toned down, I think.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel now with your grandmother there? Now that you've confronted her?
Better.
Mm-hmm. So let's find out what happens now. I'd like for you to close that scene, and then let's go now to another important scene that's impacting your life. What happens?
I think there's a war.
Mm-hmm.
We're hiding?
Mm-hmm. Where are you hiding?
In the house.
Who is the war with?
I don't know.
Who's hiding with you?
My children, my grandmother.
Mm-hmm. Where exactly are you hiding?
In our house.
Mm-hmm. Where's your husband?
I think he went to war.
So let's see what happens next. What happens now?
Everything is better. We, the good soldiers came by.
Mm-hmm.
Everything has gone away.
Where is your husband?
I think he's back.
Mm-hmm.
And I really love to see him.
Mm-hmm.
That he's back and safe. The kids too.
Mm-hmm. So it made you appreciate him even more.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So now let's go to when you're a lot older. Close that scene and let's travel through time and see what happens in your life as you age. Where are you?
I don't know. I think I'm old.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
She's 60-something.
Mm-hmm. Look around you. Where are you?
My old grandfather's house.
Mm-hmm. Your old grandfather's house?
Mm-hmm. Where we had the wake.
Mm-hmm. Who's in your life now?
I'm alone.
Mm-hmm. What happened to your husband?
I don't know.
Flashback, and you'll know the answer.
I think he was ill.
Mm-hmm.
Not pneumonia, but something with her lungs.
Mm-hmm. Was that a long time ago or recent?
Long time.
So you've been alone for a long time?
Mm-hmm.
So check in with your body. How does your body feel now?
Old.
Mm-hmm.
White hair and a bun. I'm in my 70s.
In your 70s. Mm-hmm. So I'd like for you now to go to the last day of your life in that lifetime. See yourself in that last day. And tell me where you are. What are you doing?
I'm in bed.
Check in with your body. How do you feel?
Old.
As you're lying there before transitioning over, what are the thoughts that are going through your head about your lifetime?
That I did good. That I was loved. That I loved. That I took advantage of my opportunities.
It was a good life.
Yes.
All right, so go ahead and take your last breath in that lifetime and transition out of that body. Feel yourself leaving that body. And as you leave that body, I want you to look back at your entire lifetime. What was the purpose of living that life? Why do you feel that you chose that lifetime the way it was?
To give and show love.
Do you feel you did that?
Yes.
What lessons did you learn?
That you can grow love.
Such as in your husband?
Yes.
You didn't love it at first. And then you loved him. So go ahead and leave that body, and I want you to tell me what happens as you leave that body behind. Where do you go? I want you to tell me everything that happens as you leave the body.
The sky, this moon, the stars, I see stars.
What else? Take me on the journey. What do you see next?
Stars.
So I want you to focus on your body as you're in that state. What does your body feel like?
As it's air.
Like air. Does it have any color to it?
White.
White. Beautiful. Does it have the same shape as it did before?
No, it looks like a comet.
It looks like a comet. Good. So let's take this comet-looking body and let's keep following the light. Tell me where you go to as you go through the stars.
I see a planet that is glistening. Really modern.
A modern?
With towers.
With towers. What color are these towers?
Silver. And sparkles are coming out of it and like orange and I'm looking down. It's very vibrant.
Very vibrant, What does the surface look like?
All I see is buildings.
Just buildings.
Modern stuff with like towers.
With towers. So let's
electronic, I don't know.
Let's get closer to these towers and let's see if you can see it from a different perspective. Can you go inside of these buildings?
I think there are people peeking out.
There's people peeking out. And what do they look like?
I can see them because they have like astronaut helmets. There's a lady that looks kind of weird.
What does she look like?
She has like a yellow body and her head looks weird.
What does it look like? What shape is it in?
I can't tell, but she has like the side of her face. It's like, I don't know, like hair is growing down. Mm-hmm. She's talking to the guy in the helmet, but she doesn't have a helmet.
Where are these people? Are they in the building?
Yeah, they're in one of the towers.
Mm-hmm. What do you think these towers are for? What's in there?
I think they're homes.
They're homes.
Modern homes.
Modern homes.
And there's little cars.
What do they look like?
Tiny. And I hear like a train.
Mm-hmm. Take a look and see if you see one.
No, I see like moving stuff, but I don't recognize what it is.
Mm-hmm. So let's get even closer and see if you can find out what this place is and how you fit into this place.
I think they knew I was coming.
Okay.
Because they looked at me like, oh yeah, there she is.
Okay, so let's go ahead and meet them and let's see what they say. Connect with them mind to mind. Tell me when you connect with them.
The guy in the helmet is telling me, that's weird. Your mom and father are waiting for you.
Mm-hmm. So where do you go next?
Go inside a building that is like a huge metallic with a lot of fluorescent lights.
Mm-hmm.
There's a huge lunchroom.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people in silver suits. Like some with helmets, some without. Everybody's having an awesome time.
Mm-hmm.
Like a happy place. They're eating stuff that is delicious, like green stuff. And
mm-hmm. What do these people look like? Do they look human?
I think so.
Mm-hmm.
And they're calling me, come over.
Mm-hmm. What name do they call you? Do they use a name?
It starts with A-G-U.
Mm-hmm.
Augustus, or something like that.
Augustus is your name?
I think so.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel but male or female there?
I think I'm male.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't think I'm either, though. Because they're in a human body, but I am still in this light.
You're still in this light.
Flying. Okay. And they're not surprised.
Mm-hmm.
They take it as something very normal.
All right, so let's see where you go to as you arrive. What happens?
I think I'm taken to a place, I go to a place like on the third floor,
mm-hmm.
and they give me a suit.
Mm-hmm. What is this suit?
This is really cute.
What does it look like?
It's like an astronaut suit.
Mm-hmm.
And I put it on, and I go down to meet them, to like get together with them. And now I'm a male,
mm-hmm.
because I feel like I'm a male.
Mm-hmm.
No, I have short hair.
Mm-hmm. Now you say you're wearing an astronaut suit. Is this a bulky suit or is this sleek?
It has like, they gave me a helmet.
Mm-hmm.
Because in case I go outside.
Mm-hmm.
I'm laughing at myself because what is this?
Mm-hmm.
Star Wars?
Mm-hmm. So what happens after you meet with them?
No, they're telling me about plans to go somewhere.
Okay, so let's...
They want me to go with them. And they're not, I'm surprised that they're not surprised that I just arrived there. Mm-hmm. They're taking it like, oh, well, whatever. Mm-hmm. Welcome back. What's next?
So how do you feel about these plans?
I'm telling them, I don't know, I'm not sure, I think I'm tired. Mm-hmm. No, wait, I'm telling them I'm going to go see my mom and dad.
Okay. So what happens now?
I'm in an apartment.
What does your apartment look like?
No, I think it's the apartment of my mom and my dad.
Mm-hmm. What does it look like?
Modern. Mm-hmm. Weird looking.
Tell me what's weird about it.
It's like, no regular sofa. It's just like linear things. Mm-hmm. And my mom is there. She has black hair with like a white streak of white hair. Mm-hmm. And she has like these two buns on the side of her head. Mm-hmm. She looks ridiculous with that white streak of gray hair. Mm-hmm. And my father's doing like a puzzle or a painting, something. Mm-hmm. And he wears glasses. And they're happy to see me.
Are they older or younger?
They're in their 50s.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
30. Mm-hmm. And they're telling me they missed me.
What else do they tell you?
They ask me about my children. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
What do you tell them?
I think I told them they'll be here later.
Mm-hmm. Who are these children that we're talking about?
I don't know. Doesn't make sense.
Mm-hmm. That's okay. So let's see what happens. What happens next? Where do you go after you visit your parents?
I think I go visit my girlfriend. Mm-hmm. She's expecting me.
What does she look like?
She's pretty. But she is some bitch. Mm. Very demanding. You told me you took so long. Mm-hmm. And I kept saying I couldn't help it. I had to be there. Mm-hmm. Took me this long. Don't blame me for it.
Mm-hmm. Take a look at her eyes and see if she reminds you of anyone you know.
No.
Okay, so let's see what happens after that. What happens with your girlfriend?
I think I leave there because I'm not up to that mm-hmm. nonsense and I'm too tired.
Where do you go?
I think to eat. Mm-hmm. At a very low-key place.
Mm-hmm. What is this place? Is it like a restaurant?
Yeah, like a restaurant. Mm-hmm. It has white, long walls, and it's like they're almost closing because it's barely nobody there. Only the server and the bar guy. Mm-hmm. But I'm not drinking. I just want food. They bring me some green, round things.
What are they?
They're fruits mm-hmm. or vegetables.
Mm-hmm. Are they cooked or are they raw?
I think they're raw. Mm-hmm.
What do they taste like?
Very good. They're so sweet. Exactly what I needed. Mm-hmm. And they gave me this, like, light, very refreshing water. Tastes like coconut water, but it's not. Mm-hmm. And that makes me feel good because I'm full now.
Mm-hmm. So where do you go after this?
Think about back to my parents.
Let's find out.
I see my mother again. Mm-hmm. And they're still there. Mm-hmm. And I go to my room and just are nagging about something. And I just go to my room and go to sleep.
Okay. So let's now close that scene, and now let's go to another important scene in the lifetime of this man. Tell me what's happening.
I'm driving. Mm-hmm.
What do you drive?
One of those little cars. Mm-hmm. They float.
They float?
Mm-hmm. I'm going to go buy something, like clothes, because I think I'm out of clothes.
Mm-hmm. Are there any other cars that you see?
Yeah, but it's like, not like here. It looks like I'm in a comic strip. Mm-hmm. Because it's weird streets and bright and whites and beige and mm-hmm. linear lines and busy, and everybody's still doing their own thing. Mm-hmm. People don't care, and people are not concerned. Mm-hmm. And I go to this place, which is like a drive-thru, mm-hmm. and I ask for clothes, and then the girl, who is kind of a robot, like, mm-hmm. knows exactly what to give me.
What does she give you?
I think a suit.
Mm-hmm. Is this a space suit?
No, it looks like a regular, like light beige suit.
Mm-hmm. Is this a one-piece suit or two-piece?
It looks like an old-school suit with shoes and, like, I want this, like a special order suit. Mm-hmm. Like a reminisce kind of suit. Mm-hmm. Like I wanted this particular suit mm-hmm. that's no longer in style.
Okay. Is that for a certain reason?
I think I'm going somewhere.
All right.
Like there's a party going on mm-hmm. and everybody's retro, dressing in retro.
Mm. So what do they look like? What do the people dress like?
Like mini skirts and I don't know. There's music. Mm-hmm. Like big band music.
Big band?
Like from the 30s.
Mm-hmm. Is that how you dressed?
I think so. Mm-hmm.
Do you meet anybody at this party?
I think I'm talking to a guy.
Mm-hmm. Who is he to you?
Just casual friend. Mm-hmm. Telling him that I just came in from Earth. Mm-hmm. And that it was very draining. Mm-hmm. That I need a break. That I don't know what I'm going to do now for, I want to chill.
Mm-hmm. All right. So let's close that scene, and now let's go to the point in that lifetime where you make a decision to do something different. Tell me what is happening.
They're calling my name.
Mm-hmm. What's your name?
Oh my God, I think they said Lucio.
Lucio? Mm-hmm.
They're telling me that I need to go back.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't want to.
Who are these people that are calling your name?
Kind of my boss, like the people who manage everything.
Mm-hmm.
They're in charge. They tell you when you're supposed to go back and...
Mm-hmm. So, Lucia, what happens now?
I don't want to go back yet. Mm-hmm. I'm tired. I'm drained. But he starts talking loud to me and screaming.
What does he say?
That I don't listen to what, that I must do what he tells me to do.
Mm-hmm. What's the reason why he wants you to go back?
Something that is left undone.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, it's something that I cheated.
Mm-hmm.
And they found out about it. And he's upset. That's why he's screaming at me.
Well, how did you cheat?
I don't know.
Are there rules that you broke?
The word that came out is that I killed somebody.
You killed somebody. Mm-hmm.
But... to make it quicker,
mm-hmm.
to leave quicker.
You killed someone to leave quicker?
Or I kill myself to leave quicker?
Mm-hmm.
They're very upset, totally. They do not allow that.
So what does that mean for you? Now that they found out.
Now I'm in the hit list. They totally dishonor and they want to make it like make me pay or make sure that I pay for that error that I did.
Mm-hmm.
Because it was on purpose. It was not a an accident. I did it on purpose.
Mm-hmm. How did you kill yourself?
I don't know, drown?
Mm-hmm. You drowned yourself?
I don't know.
Have them show you how you'd killed yourself.
I don't know if I kill somebody and hold their head under the water.
Mm.
That's what I'm seeing, that I hold somebody's head.
So you killed somebody?
Mm-hmm.
And that's not allowed?
No, that's cheating.
Mm-hmm. Did you kill yourself too? Or no?
I don't know how I made it back so soon.
Okay. So what happens now?
I'm punished.
In what way?
They're going to make me unhappy.
Mm-hmm. In what way?
They're going to take away something that I love.
Which is what?
my children.
Tell me what happens.
I'm very, very resentful. I mean, not real. I'm ashamed. I even tell them that there was someone else who did it.
You lied?
Yeah.
Did they know the truth?
Yes. They have all the facts. But they don't want me, they don't want to punish me. They want me to heal that mistake that I did within myself.
And how do they do, how do you do that?
They want me to talk to somebody bigger, to teach me how to correct that.
All right. So let's see where you go to learn that. What happens next?
I'm in a room, in a classroom.
Are you by yourself or are there other people there?
There's 15, 20 guys.
Just men?
I think so.
How are you all dressed there?
They're men with white hair. And with like, I think robes or capes. They're very upset with me. I'm on one side of the room and they're all facing me. They cannot believe what I did.
What do they tell you?
That is a very bad, that I did something unlawful. They don't want to tell my parents because it would destroy them. And I beg them to help me be better.
What do they say?
That they will help me. That they love me. And they know that I am good.
Who are these men?
They're like the all-knowing people. They have love. They have knowledge. The love is overwhelming. The heart is tingles with love when you speak to them. And they just want us to do good, to love each other. And they're gonna show them the way so that doesn't happen anymore.
So how is it that you learn from them? In what way? Do you go to school?
I think they take you to like a glass and they show you how to react to things.
Where is
this
glass?
They point.
Where is this glass?
Somewhere in that building where they all hang around or live. It's like a mirror that they show you, look, you did this, this is not how you do it. You were supposed to do this. And
so they're showing you your mistakes?
Yes, and how to be better. But I'm thinking I thought I got away with it. Mm-hmm. Because I'm sneaky in some part of me.
Mm-hmm. Do they know that?
Of course they do. Mm-hmm. They just make believe that they don't. Mm-hmm. That I'm they're buying it. Mm-hmm. But they still love me. They're not going to give up on me.
So how long do you have to be there with them?
They told me 5 months. Mm-hmm. But it's all up to me.
Depends on how quickly you learn.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And if they see that I truly have changed from the heart, they love you so much that they kill you with their love. Mm-hmm. You can, they make you say the truth because they're so loving that you can't lie to them.
So let's advance through that and see how you change, how you're transformed with this love. What happens?
I'm sitting somewhere with my children. Mm-hmm. I'm older. I'm still in that place. Mm-hmm. I'm fatter. I'm wiser.
Are you still learning?
I've learned, and I'm telling my kids what not to do. Mm-hmm. And the mistake that I did, that I regretted it. But I saw the light and was able to work myself out of that. Mm-hmm. And that they shouldn't make the same mistake, always listen.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel there?
At peace, mm-hmm. Very thankful, very very secure that they love me and they accepted me and mm-hmm. they forgive me.
Did you forgive yourself for that?
I think yes. Mm-hmm. I'm changed. Mm-hmm. The sneakiness is gone away because I felt love.
Love heals.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So, Lucia, let's find out when it is that you decide to go back. I want you to see yourself now. At the moment of when you make that decision to finally go back in a new life.
It wasn't up to me. Mm-hmm. It was up to the elders. And they told me, even though we loved you, we forgive you. You need to go through your own skin. Mm-hmm. To feel what you did, the hurt that you gave someone.
So let's find out how you choose that body. Who helps you with this?
I don't know. I think they do it. Mm-hmm.
What's the process of returning?
You come out as a baby.
Mm-hmm.
It's all pre-done.
Mm-hmm. The elders help you.
I think they decide amongst themselves.
Mm-hmm. You didn't have any say in it?
No. They only took my remorse.
Mm-hmm.
And decided amongst themselves what should they do with me.
Mm-hmm. Were these all men?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why are there no women in this? These elders?
I don't know if they have no sex.
Mm-hmm.
We can tell if they're one or the other.
Mm. So these elders really have no gender?
I think so.
Mm-hmm. They just feel like men?
They just feel like men.
But they're both?
Maybe.
Mm-hmm. All right. I know that you could have shown Alina many different lifetimes today. Why did you choose to show her the life of this woman who eventually fell in love with her husband?
It's her own life.
Mm-hmm. It's her own life? Can you explain that?
It's what she's been through.
It's what she's been through. So has she repeated this life already?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell her why you showed it to her? What were you trying to tell her?
That love is always there.
Mm-hmm.
It's in her heart.
Mm-hmm.
It always is. She doesn't need it to come out.
She doesn't need it to come out?
She doesn't need no one to take it out.
Mm-hmm. You also showed her the life of this man who seemed to have been in an afterlife. Where was this place? These metallic buildings with the green, but...
Another planet.
Another planet. Is that her home planet?
No.
What is this place?
A stationary place.
A stationary place? Is this like a way station where people go between lives?
Yes.
Mm. So does she always return to the same planet between lives?
No.
Is this the one where she was before this one?
Yes.
Okay. Who was it that she killed? In what lifetime was that? You didn't show her that life.
I think her husband.
Her husband. Was it the husband in that same life?
Yes.
Hmm. But she said that he was sick. Did she accelerate his death?
Yes.
By killing him?
Yeah, she was compassionate.
Mm.
She didn't want to see him suffer.
So she killed him to accelerate.
Yeah, but she loved him a lot.
Mm-hmm.
He was suffering.
But that was not the right way to do it.
No.
Mm-hmm.
Only God says.
Mm-hmm. So that's why the elders were so upset at her.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That you're not allowed to take somebody else's life, even if they're dying.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Is there anything else that I could have asked today that I didn't, that you would like to tell Alina?
No.
Very good. Five, wide awake now. Wide awake, feeling wonderful all over.
Mira que empecé a sudar.
You're doing great. What amazing journey.
What the hell was that?
That was fantastic.
What was that? No, no, I'm still in the planet, by the way.
That was so vivid, wasn't it?
So
that's your way station. That's where you go between lives.
Have you heard of that before?
Everybody goes to a different place. That was very vivid. This is like
Yeah. I still see it.
It's fantastic.
Oh yeah, me.
How long do you think this journey was? Just guess. How did it feel?
What do you mean, how long?
How long do you feel you were on this journey?
An hour?
An hour and 40 minutes.
Wow.
Unbelievable, huh?
Pero, why did that name Lucio come up?
That was a name.
That was weird.
Yeah.
Of all the names.
Yeah.
So, what did I get that... I have to listen to the whole thing again.
Do you feel like you're forgetting some of it?
See.
Yeah.
Totally.
Yeah.
See, I don't connect.
You feel disconnected, like
totally. Like I think about the lady.
Yeah.
And the man and the.
Well, what happened is that you were in love with your husband, but he was sick. So for you not to see him suffer, you drowned him.
Is that what I did?
Yeah, and you quickened it, which you shouldn't have, because only God can take lives. So when you got back, you thought you got away with it, and
they told me no.
Right. So you had to really, this life, you had to pay for that, and you've paid for that.
So that's what it was?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I didn't connect.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's why. That's why.
And why am I paying so weirdly?
Because you had to, you had to suffer for it. You had to go endure. You had to learn patience. But wow. You want to keep this private, or you want to share your past lives?
Yeah, sure.
You want to put about the past lives? I thought that was pretty interesting.
Really?
Yeah, that's cool. These little cars that are. You were so detailed.
And and it was like I was watching a movie. I arrived there like a flash of light, and they were like, "Hey, hi, oye, go get dressed, cause we're gonna have a party." But I got encounter.
Yeah, then you wanted to go see your mom and dad.
Yes,
mom was wearing.
Because this is the mom and dad. Listen, this is the mom and dad that died. I think.
Ah.
When
you were little. Oh, that's where they were. Oh.
Cause they told me we weren't being expecting you.
Oh, I see.
This is a novela.
It is. Let me disconnect you.
Estoy sudando, pero I wasn't cold. I mean, I wasn't hot until the last 5 minutes.
So let's say goodbye to everybody.
Wow. I know. So tell me, you said you're still in this place.
I'm still in that planet.
Yeah.
Still driving in my little car.
Yeah.
I'm still somebody threw a bomb on me. I don't know. I'm still.
You're still floating?
Floating.
So what did you think about the experience?
I don't know. Did I watch this movie somewhere?
You said you felt like you were watching a movie.
That I was watching a movie and I was looking down and telling you the story.
So did you think that you could be hypnotized?
No.
So what was the hypnosis? What did it feel like for you?
It was like someone within me was talking,
mm-hmm.
was letting me relax and talk,
yeah,
and answer you. And I was fully aware,
yeah,
but it was just easing the words out.
Mm-hmm.
They just came out without me wanting to. Don't laugh.
So did you prepare for this at all?
No.
So what was tell everybody what's the best way to prepare for this?
Come like that you're coming to a pajama party. Yes. I truly recommend it. You have no idea what I found out.
So Alina and I used to work together at the University of Miami.
Yes.
And you heard about this and you got curious.
Through my friends, and mm-hmm. I set the appointment how many months ago?
Oh my God, it's like 6 months ago.
And I did not prepare. I saw the video. I went to her website last night, actually. Filled out the paper about an hour before I got here.
Yeah, and the questions were really simple. We didn't go into the questions. We're not going to be including that in the video. We just wanted to do the past lives. But your questions were very simple. I think you only had like 5 questions or 6 questions, and that was it. And that allows, really, less is more. The less questions you have really allows for just this thing to just flow. So you think it was worth it?
Yes, and I didn't come with any preconceived ideas, or I just let it go.
Just let it flow.
Yes, ma'am. I'll be back for more.
For the continuation.
For the continuation of the novela, yes.
Absolutely. So if you would like a session with me, just go to albaweinman.com and just sign up. It is very easy. And hopefully we'll see you sometime soon. Thank you very much for watching.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Give me a hug. Give me a hug.
Oh, my God.
Oh.